Okay, let's go to fetch. There. Is that John?
There you are. You boys ready?
Of course.
What else do you know about this guy?
Not much. Just he's some slick little greasy-haired European. Clearly got power and money. Now, listen. If we go in there and start shooting up the place, boy's gonna get shot, that I guarantee. Better like this, we're gonna have a lot of protection.
Ain't no one gonna get shot, Arthur, so everyone just relax. We'll charm them. Trust me. This the place?
Must be.
You okay, John?
I guess.
Excuse me, sir. We have an appointment to see Mr. Bronte.
Who are you?
You get your boss down here and now so we can talk about this like gentlemen.
Run along now, boy.
Was that the special Dutch charm I heard so much about?
Relax.
That was the charm.
I got this.
Don't worry, boys. We come in peace.
We just need to straighten a couple of things out with your boss.
Chi sono sti buffoni?
Sono qui per picciotto.
Coi soldi?
Why do you take his son?
Excuse me.
I said, why did you take his son? We ain't got no problems with you, sir. Nor you with us. But if you want to start one, there's gonna be a lot of folks dead in this room before it's done.
So, you walk into my city, stinking of shit and looking like this, and you come into my house before you have a bath and you tell me how to act? You ask me to show compassion. Have I not shown you almost infinite compassion already by simply allowing you to breathe in my presence?
Indeed you have. Now, we are simple country folk. All we have is each other. And you have gone and you have took his son over some dispute with some inbred ex-slavers. It ain't got nothing to do with any one of us.
You had nothing to do with destroying the liquor business!
We was innocent bystanders. And that which we weren't innocent of, well, we most surely were ignorant of.
Twist words, you lie shamelessly. You think you are better than everyone else. Ti adoro. Date da bere sti uomini. Angelo Bronte.
Dutch Vanderlyn. Arthur Morgan.
Arthur, the pleasure is mine.
John Marston.
All mine, please.
So, can my friend have his son?
Of course, of course. But should I be out of pocket over a misunderstanding? Of course, I know you would not want that, huh?
No.
No, no, no. So, how about this? You perform a simple job for me, and you get your son back.
What is it?
A couple of people have taken to grave robbing in this cemetery.
Well, that is a fine place for it, the best.
I love this guy. I love you. See, they've taken not only to desecrating the dead, but they've done so without paying a tribute to the living. Thing is, they see my men, of course they run a mile. So maybe you two head off, huh? And you, Mr. van der Linde, why you tell me more about my manners? Salute.
Salute.
Grave robbers? You think he's taking us for a fool?
What did I do? No.
What choice do we have?
No. None, sorry, Mickey. Sorry. I didn't mean it. Sorry.
This
sorry.
Is idiotic.
Sorry.
You gonna mount up?
Sorry, Mickey.
Are we doing this or not? Bit.
I'm taller than Mickey, John.
Okay, boy. Come on, then.
You know where the cemetery is?
I think so. Pretty sure I rode by it earlier. It's real impressive.
You know, you did good holding your tongue in there.
Do you trust one word that comes out of that bastard's mouth? We don't even know where Jack is.
Listen, we found Bronte. We got in there. Dutch is with him now. All things considered, it could have gone a lot worse.
That poor kid. I ain't been a good father to him. I hope he's okay.
He'll be fine. I figure the Braithwaites were going to hold Jack ransom for all the money we cost him. Must have sent him here so we couldn't get to him. But Bronte knows by now there's no Braithwaites left to pay him. Jack ain't much use to him anymore. Let's just get this done. Let Dutch handle the rest.
I just hope you're right. Okay. I think this is it. Keep it down. Let's hitch your horses up ahead. This way. Come on. Let's find him and get the hell out of here.
Search the cemetery for the grave robbers. Why would you rob a grave?
Keep it down. Don't want them to bolt on us.
Who's that? I saw someone running.
Hey, did you hear that?
Hold on. Hey there, boy. Let's keep looking.
Here's something.
Wait.
You should get yourself home. I know, but he won't care once we get the boy back.
That bastard better keep his word. Of all the ways I thought today was gonna turn out, it sure weren't one of them.
Huge. Stay quiet. We don't want to spook them.
Where are they? Destroying graves.
be around here someplace.
Okay, but we'll need to be quick.
We can't go back to Bronte empty-handed. Let's have a look where they first shot at us from.
Robbing grave robbers. We've hit the big time.
Wait. Is this kissing time, John?
Come on. Let's quickly check that spot where it all kicked off. Like I said, let's look around where they jumped us.
Where was it?
We can't go back to Bronte with nothing to show for it, Arthur.
Okay, okay.
Think there might be something in here. Got it.
Good. Now let's get out of here. Shit, it's the law. Let's go. Maybe we can get out that gate. Locked. Let's just track back to where we came in.
Damn it. Come on.
Let's go around the side.
Still bleeding. Must just been killed. They're still here.
Come on. Stay together.
Stealthy, stealthy.
Back to Dutch.
Okay, escape.
Well, it's lucky I ain't a religious man.
Let's just get back there, collect our side of the deal.
You all right?
He best not be playing games with us.
He almost certainly is. Let's just see. Keep your head. Act normal.
How's he even gonna know we did what he asked?
I got a feeling most things around here get back to him pretty fast.
Sorry.
Like I said, we should see where we're at once we got Jack.
All right. Let's get this done. Come on, Arthur.
took your time.
Jack, where's your host?
Like I said, you took your time.
I'm glad to see you.
Let's get going. What a fine man. Hey, friend, thank Mr. Bronte for everything.
Yeah, I'm fine.
Come on.
You know, Arthur, Mr. Bronte has invited us to a garden party at the mayor's house.
Really?
And us, just simple country boys.
Jack is safe.
Let's go! We have a new camp set up, Jack. You're gonna love it. All right, let's get this boy back to his mother.
You sure you're okay, son?
I'm fine. Papa Bronte said you'd come for me.
Papa Bronte?
I'm sorry.
What for?
For that. For taking so long.
I had a fun time. I had my own room with a big bed and a toy box. And lots of books.
That sounds like a good environment for a kid.
What's that?
It's food. It looks like worms, but it's delicious.
Is that right?
Papa Bronte teach me lots of Italian words.
Don't call him that, please.
You know, cavallo?
Cavallo?
That's horse. And pantofola? That's a slipper.
A slipper?
They gave me two pairs. One for day and one for night.
Well,
so they were nice to him.
I'm just glad you're all right.
Oh, yes. I had the best time. But I can't wait to see Mama. Did she miss me?
She
had the best time.
Like you wouldn't know.
Sure, it was a great environment for a kid.
You too, Uncle Arthur. Did you catch the bad guys?
Which ones?
At the graveyard. Uncle Dutch and Papa Bronte told me.
Just Mr. Bronte.
Yeah. Me and your pa dealt with them.
I told him you would.
Wait till you see this new camp.
Not another one.
Well, this one's got a house. Not as nice as Mr. Bronte's, mind you.
That's okay.
We'll get you settled and cleaned up in no time.
Oh, I had a bath last night.
Of course you did.
Sure, you had a great time. That's kind of sad. He was happy there.
Hey, they're back! I think I see Jack!
Abigail! Abigail! We got you, your son, everything!
We got him!
Mama!
He's fine!
I'm fine, Mama. They fed me good.
I tell
you. You ever eat that?
Come here, you silly boy. You got him. You got my son back. Dutch, Arthur, thank you. Thank you.
Oh, she's not thinking, John.
I got my son back!
Jack, they have trouble.
Jack, how are you, boy?
I'm fine, thanks.
Everything's okay now. Abigail?
Can I go play now?
John looks so sad.
Well, we met Mr. Bronte. He is quite a character.
Is he now?
You ever meet an Italian strong man before?
Not outside of a circus.
Well, let me tell you all about him. John, you go be with your family. Arthur, thank you. Boys! We got some work to do. Interesting work. But first, let's have a drink. We got Jack back!
Well, the boy's safe, thank goodness.
Thank you, Arthur. I don't know how to say it. Thank you.
I understand. Come on. Do as Dutch says. Go be with your family.
Yeah, be with your family.
He's back, all right.
Hey, make some room for John there.
Come on, are we celebrating or what?
Everybody's happy.
Very well. That's good.
Thanks, Karen. Oh, it's
you all right, Charles?
Yeah, just taking it all in.
Loitering suspiciously as usual.
I'm just trying to give you all your moment.
Suspicious.
Wow, very kind. You okay, Sadie?
Sure. You boys did good.
Thank you.
Well, we got lucky this time.
Let's drink. Why are they back here?
Not joining in?
Not really in the mood.
Okay. Okay, I'll catch you later then.
Well, I'm not much company. Take care.
Okay.
You ain't joining the party, Reverend?
I don't want to ruin it.
Stop feeling sorry for yourself. All right, well, I should be getting on.
Molly's okay. Not happy.
Happy Miss Grimshaw.
Very well done.
Can I
play with you?
Well done, Jack.
Mirando por debajo.
You know, me and you should go get some drinks in San Denis sometime.
I ain't sure that's a good idea.
Ah, come on. It was one bad night. If you say so.
Paradise, an unspoiled paradise.
Yeah, I hope so.
Faith, Arthur, have a little faith.
Okay, well, let's talk more later.
Okay.
Did I ever tell you boys about the time I was hanged?
I think so.
Tell us again.
Sure.
So I got caught doing something or other. I was just a kid, 17, 18, long before I met Dutch. I was newly an orphan. Anyway, I got caught by some hill country sheriff stealing a chicken, I think it was. And he decided I was going to be hanged for it.
For a chicken?
Yes. Only some folks thought it was unfair. And at the hanging, there was a riot. They went to lynch me. But someone I never saw, he shot the rope. Clean through. Instead, they hanged the sheriff. And I got away with nothing more than a sore neck.
Well, was you scared?
Absolutely petrified.
Well, I'll play something for Jack later.
I'll ask him in a bit.
Okay. Anyway, I won't disturb you.
Okay, then.
We did it.
Well done.
That's a weight off, all right. Well, I should get back to it.
Thanks.
They're singing.
He asked me for a candlestick to light him up to bed.
All right.
He asked me for my
Arthur.
see a smile on your mama's
Nobody
face.
Nobody ever gonna take him again. I swear.
Okay, I'll catch you later then.
So, okay, Uncle Arthur.
I was thinking, maybe it would be a little easier for me to keep an eye on him if we all stayed together. You know, in my room.
You mean like a normal family?
Look around you. Ain't nothing normal about any of this. Take this fella for one.
Man don't just change like the wind, Abigail.
Oh, they're not
sleeping Thought you'd
together.
Have known that by now.
No, Arthur, some folks change. Others is just too dumb.
Look after that kid.
Oh, I will.
Good night.
He's a brave boy.
See, they're staying in a different place.
But I think I know what that'll be like. And I'm good.
Come on, Kieran, join in.
Oh, no, I'm okay. Thank you. I'll just watch.
Suit yourself, then.
Cheer up, Molly. We got Jack back.
I'm fine.
Could have fooled me. All right, well, I should be getting on.
Talk to you later.
Okay.
On board the Heartland stage, pulling all about the sheets, and make love to about the sheets. We started at
There he is, Mr. Hoy and Morton.
All opposition they defies, people must root hog or die.
They're fighting.
Get some rest.
It's
Batman.
Her in a band.
I ought to be talking to my man.
Misty blood tobacco smoke.
A lady, well bred, not salt, would run up off the street back. Go be a such a
man. Boxers, the care of a talk of.
Oh, yes, I can see. Very lady.
What is wrong with me? What is wrong with you? What is wrong with you?
I have the feeling you're about to tell me.
You have ruined my life.
Well, have you walking on behind you? On your shoulders,
I'm sure you do. You see everything differently.
When you're pale, you pay. You'll have to walk only
halfway. Leaving
alone. Sad with a cunning laugh. You'll have to push the other hat. They started as a
Is she okay?
Clearly not. It's getting very tiresome.
Yeah, she seems pretty worked up. Okay, well, let's talk more later.
Whatever you say.
They're not happy.
There he is, old Arthur.
Miss Karen?
The strong, silent, manly one of us.
You're drunk.
This ain't drunk, Arthur.
It smells drunk.
Well, then don't smell it, you stuck-up piece of shit. God damn you.
Take it easy, Miss Karen.
Listen. Next time, listen. Faith. Faith is all that matters. We had faith, and we made it. We are gonna make it.
Okay, Pearson?
We have a plan. My friends. My loved ones. A plan. It is a real plan. We are gonna leave this place, and we are gonna find our own paradise. Our own heaven. Tahiti!
Fiji!
Fiji? Australia!
Australia?
The real new world! Not this godforsaken dump that all of Europe's detritus has acted out its vengeance on! We are gonna be free! Free!
Oh, but the storm is coming.
Yes, we are!
kind of...
Remember, it's your fault that boy went missing.
It wasn't... I mean, I said that I'm sorry.
Count yourself real lucky.
I always...
Okay, I'll catch you later then.
Yeah, it was good talking to you.
Chips around my coffee, I boil without being ground.
What is it?
You all right, Jose?
I'm very all right.
Good. All right, well, I should be getting on.
All right, Arthur.
This is not my room? Oh, maybe I'm upstairs. Okay, nice place. Aww, so cute. No, don't jump out. Don't jump out. Oh my gosh. Can I sleep? It's morning. A letter. How can I read the letter? I want to read the letter. Not jump out. See the letter post.
My dear Arthur, I hope this letter finds you well. I wanted to thank you for your help with Jamie. He and Daddy are still arguing, but I understand that Jamie is thinking about going back to college. Whatever happens, I believe you saved his life, and we are all truly grateful. Oh, Arthur. I have made such a mess of my life, time and again. Why can I not change and be the woman I want to be? Why couldn't you change and be a man and put down all those fantasies that shroud your judgment? Life is very confusing, and I see now that I am not very good at it. I'm afraid we've got ourselves into another mess. It's not my fault, but I need your help. I'm staying at the Hotel Grand in Saint Denis. Oh, Arthur, I know it is wrong to ask you, but I have nobody else, and for what we once had together, I beg of you, even though I am ashamed to do so. Yours, Mary.
Yours? Maybe I'm the only one that Mary can rely on. This place is fancy. Okay. Restock. Molly?
What?
Hello. You seem miles away.
I'm fine.
Anyway, not my business, I guess.
Go away!
Okay, you're so mad. Can I play piano? Oh, it's all broken. Okay.
That last drink.
I'll be here.
Mary Beth needs to speak to you. Okay. Where is Mary Beth? Larry is drunk again.
Tumble and roar.
Oh, my head is pounding. There he is.
A fay
Arthur.
No, and Thrice,
how are
no.
You?
Well, I'm well, I think. It's been quite a run we've had, but we're still alive.
So, no regrets?
Regrets for what?
Well, for joining this band of maniacs.
If you're a girl without means in this world, life is very scary. You boys care for me before no one cared for me. Well, life weren't very nice, Arthur. Not after Mama got typhoid, and that was a long time ago.
Sure.
What about you? I heard you ran into that Mary girl.
Mary girl.
Yep.
And?
Got me thinking how that all ended. Long time ago now.
What happened?
Well, she didn't love me enough, I guess. Or I wouldn't change.
Huh. Well, she was a fool then, Arthur.
Well, she put a lot of good years in on an outlaw. She definitely was a fool.
In these books, life seems so simple, but in reality, I can't make head nor tail of it.
Mr. Morgan, we have a problem.
What?
A real problem. It's Tilly.
What?
Tilly?
She's been taken by them foreman brothers she used to run with. Come along!
The foreman brothers? What are they doing here?
Well, I don't know what they've been doing here, but I can tell you what they're going to be doing here. Dying.
Sure.
Okay.
Do we need more guns?
You and I can handle this, Arthur.
Where are we heading?
I'll tell you on the way.
Was pushed away.
Just get going. All right, head for Rhodes. And quick.
She's in Rhodes?
No. She's at a place called Bradley's House, just west of there.
How do you know?
When we first got here, she told me she was worried that our camp was near a safe house that gang she ran with used from time to time.
And you told Dutch?
No. She spoke to me in confidence. I suppose I didn't think it would be a problem.
And now it is.
Oh, yes.
What do they want with her anyway? I think I saw one of the foremans hassling her in Valentine.
Yes. They probably followed us down here. You don't know what happened? She killed one of them, for good reason, but clearly they don't see it that way.
Tilly?
Yes. Young Tilly Jackson isn't as sweet and innocent as you might think. But like I say, she was defending herself. She fled and fell in with us right after that. I just hope we can get to her in time.
It's not too far.
If they've touched a single hair on that girl's head, I will eviscerate the sons of bitches.
See? You do care, Miss Grimshaw.
Yeah.
Of course I care. About all of you fools.
She's like an ass.
Firmer hand than others. You especially. Anyway, talking of folks disappearing, have you seen that boy Kieran since the party for Jack? Okay, I think that's the place up ahead.
What about Kieran?
I think there's a guard.
I'll deal with him.
Whoa. What you want?
Kind sir, we're lost and in need of some help.
Oh, get out of here.
Oh, I see that kindly face of yours, and I know that for the right inducement, a gentleman such as yourself could be mighty kind.
Now get out of here.
Oh, now you keep saying that. You don't mean nothing by it.
I said.
You said.
Oh,
God. Well, what are you waiting for? Get in there and find our girl.
Okay.
What the hell? What the hell you think you're doing?
You thought it's okay.
Aww, Arthur's so
let's
sweet.
Go.
Oh, come along, miss. Thank you, both of you.
What happened?
It was Anthony Foreman. He thinks he owns me.
I remember. Where is he?
He went out hunting or something. They were following him, I think.
Well, we killed those fellas there.
There they are.
Come on.
Tilly, grab that gun. Anyone approaches, shoot them.
Oh, don't worry. I'll be just fine. Now catch that bastard. The one in front.
Bring him back alive. I ain't done with him yet.
All right, get after them.
It's okay.
There, straight ahead. I saw him go through those bushes.
This place is hard to ride.
You've got a couple more seconds to regret what you did. We're coming for you, you bastards. They're heading down the hill to the water.
You crazy old hag.
And there they are by the shoreline. Oh, look at these cowards.
Oh, you got me.
With pleasure. Let's go for a ride.
You have the first idea what you're getting into. I'm Anthony Foreman.
Well, thanks for the introduction, Anthony. Is that Foreman with an A? I want the Undertaker to spell it right.
Funny bastard. Who are you?
Watch.
Oh, shit. Funny bastard. Who are you running with?
She didn't tell you?
She didn't tell me nothing. This rope is cutting into me.
Don't feel so good when you're the one tied up, does it?
She killed my goddamn cousin.
Oh, don't worry. You'll be seeing him soon enough.
What are you gonna do with me?
Shut the hell up.
Go to hell.
I ain't sure yet. Reckon I'll let Tilly decide what you deserve.
You're wasting your time with that girl. She's a liar. She'll screw you over like she did me. I should have shot the bitch yesterday like I said I would.
You just shut your mouth now, Anthony. I've heard enough. Son of a coward.
All right, damn it.
So he's still alive then?
Yes.
You see this girl? You leave her alone.
She killed my cousin.
Your goddamn cousin had it coming, Anthony Foreman. I don't care if she shot your daddy and cooked your mama for breakfast.
Oh.
She's mine. She ain't yours.
You know, a friend of mine, he always says, revenge is a fool's game. Now, you want all your boys dead? She had her reasons.
We was family, Tilly Jackson.
You Foreman boys ain't no kind of family I want. Kill him, Arthur!
You want that?
I want him to go away and tell the remaining of his cousins and the clowns he rides with to leave me alone!
Now, you think you can do that, Anthony? Or should I slit your throat and just save us all the bother?
I'll leave you alone. History is done.
History is never done. It's your call, Arthur. But I'd slit his throat.
But
go on.
But Tilly didn't want
finish
to,
the
so.
Bastard. Let's get you home.
What about me?
Now get out of here.
This horse looks like a zebra.
All of them did it.
What is wrong with you?
Hey, will you help a fella out? Come on.
Get yourself some real food,
I know
food,
you got
huh?
some money. Listen, you have to take this.
Okay.
That's real kind of
you. Ginseng elixir? Thank you.
I lost my money playing poker.
Oh, no.
I know where a good game is. Above the gunsmith.
Robbery?
Real.
Rumor has it the gunsmith of St. Denis is running a profitable gambling operation. Looking around the shop to investigate. Okay.
Hush, hush.
Above the gunsmith, huh? Oh, keep that in mind.
Hey, mister.
Is it here? What? I guess it's here. Oh, maybe upstairs.
Enjoy the show, if that's possible. It's a free
What's this show, then?
Mr. Charles Chatternay. Go and see for yourself, but don't blame me.
Don't blame me. Why?
I just don't like how much time you're spending with the man is all.
Just wait until you see his work. It's very progressive.
Well, I'm not so very sure how I feel about progression, paintings or otherwise.
Come on. You won't have seen the like of it before, I promise.
Maybe that's a good thing. Hold on. Let me compose myself.
Hello, ma'am.
We'll miss the party.
I think that it's Greek.
Ma'am?
Or could be Roman.
Okay.
Hey there.
That's far too modern for my tastes.
Mr. Chatternay, he's just a terror. It's making me blush.
That drawing is
Look
hilarious.
At these idiots.
Excuse me, Mr. Chatternay. Couldn't you have painted some drawers on her?
Madame, I paint her in her natural state, as she was and will be in paradise.
There's nothing natural about that.
Clothes are civilization, repression, death. To be naked is to be free, innocent, alive. Like Buddha said, you know, we are all just here to fuck.
What?
Well, that explains the decadence of those Hottentots.
Hey, you got a picture of my wife here. In her delicates.
Married? Oh. Is that your behind? Why would you be showing it to that man?
That's my mama. As nude as the day she was born.
Stop looking at my husband's buttocks.
Stop looking at my mama.
Well, maybe she shouldn't expose herself like that.
This is disgusting.
The nerve on you.
That's it.
What?
Oh, come on, Mildred. This is no place for us.
Come here, son of a bitch.
You filthy little man.
Oh, there, real model.
I'm coming after you, Frenchie.
Hey.
All right.
What the hell is happening here?
Hey, where you gone off to, Frenchman?
Where's
right, Jeff. This show is well and truly over. Let's get out of here. Come on. I know a place where I can
disappear for a few days.
This way, come on. I think we are okay. The exhibition, what can you say? It was not boring, huh?
That it was not.
Architect people, push them. I thought I was a fraud, a no-talent brush washer. Now I'm not sure. We provoke emotions, no?
You keep provoking emotions like that, and all your canvases will have punch holes through.
I told you I was a whole ass.
You did. And you are. Now maybe go be an asshole somewhere else for a while.
Ah, here we are. I know a lady over here. She may let me stay for a while.
Good luck.
Let's see, there's a band of outlaws
that
robbing
picture I gave you, it would be worth something someday. I can feel it.
Perhaps. Right now, seems like the only thing it'd get me is kicking the balls.
Oh, you are funny, you know. I hope to see you again sometime. My angel, my little bird, it's me!
That was hilarious.
How do you do?